Thanks for tuning into Dirty Teeth. I'm sitting here in beautiful Idaho, and right now I'm watching it just dump snow outside. Here, take a look. I was just checking out the bikepacking.com website and their editor's dozen for 2022. It got me thinking about additions and upgrades I've made to my own bikepacking kit this year. I'm never stoked with everything I try, and some things wind up being massive fails. Not these. These are the bits that have helped me refine my bikepacking kit and make every adventure that much more enjoyable. So in no particular order, these are my 11 favorite bikepacking purchases and upgrades I've made this year. And by the way, if you just want to cut to the chase, I've got everything listed with links and timestamps in the description below. This is an ultralight long sleeve hooded shirt made by Anetic. In August, I headed to Moab, Utah to start working on a movie. I was looking for something to keep me cool while working outside in the 100 degree sun all day. I had never heard of Anetic, but I came across this shirt, I think in like my Instagram feed or something. They must have caught me searching, Big Brother was watching. Anyway, it's become my favorite summer work shirt, and it's pretty much the perfect warm to hot summer bikepacking shirt. I normally love wearing sun hoodies for mountain biking and bikepacking. This is basically a souped up, ultralight, button down sun hoodie. It has useful pockets galore everywhere. For snacks, chapstick, your phone, car keys, whatever. You can never have enough pockets for bikepacking. The sleeves and hood are made of an ultralight cooling fabric that's stretchy and breathable. It feels amazing to the touch and still offers UPF 30 plus sun protection. There are thumb holes in the sleeves, which is a nice touch, and the back is vented to let hot air escape. This shirt is definitely not cheap, but it's worth every penny. And I think my wife just scored me one as a Christmas present for 40% off during a Thanksgiving sale.
Hey!
Here is a cheapy Amazon sitting pad. Super light, foam, it's kind of like a mini Thermarest pad. Weighs next to nothing, but comes in super handy. Whether you're sitting down on the ground or on a tree stump, it adds a layer of comfort and luxury. Or if you want a doormat by your tent or bivy, or want something clean to stand on while you're changing your clothes, this always comes in handy. It's also great for winter bikepacking. I use it as a kneeling pad for insulation while I'm lighting my stove. I'm gonna buy a couple more because an unnamed member of my family keeps stealing it. This is a 3D printed Garmin eTrex mount adapter. I love it. I made a video review of these items already, so check that out for a geeky rundown and all the details. If you don't want to waste your time watching that video, here's the quick of it. If you're using a Garmin eTrex for navigation, this improves that junky slider mounting that they have on it. You slide your eTrex right into this thing, and then it adapts it to the quarter 20 mount, which is much more popular and has plenty of aftermarket options. Click, click, bloom, bloom, bloom. You can basically mount this to anything, anywhere on your bike. Done. They're cheap and made by a good dude who's also a fellow bikepacker, so show some support. The Monet Light Bar is a game changer on my fat bike, and I'll be taking it on the Iditarod. It's made by Shel Monet. I hope I didn't butcher his name. He's also a fellow bikepacker known for making sweet custom bikes out of the back of a Wonder Bread truck. He recently started a podcast as well called Bikes, Bikes, Bikes. He's got some great guests, so check it out. Anywho, this bar checks all my boxes and is comfy for long days in the saddle. It has 2.5 inches of rise, which gets me up into a relaxed, comfy riding position. It also relieves pressure from my hands, which increases blood flow, thus keeping them warmer inside my pogies. At 825 millimeters, it's nice and wide. This allows me to slide my controls inboard slightly, allowing me to access my bar ends with pogies on. 12 degrees of sweep is nice and comfy on the wrists. The BMX crossbar adds a little steeze and also opens it up for the potential of mounting lights and anything else you need. Did I mention it's carbon and only weighs 280 grams? Winner, winner, chicken dinner. This is none other than a Devil's Kettle XL made by Sedaro in Minnesota. It's a huge feed bag with a magnetic top closure. It's designed specifically to swallow up a 32-ounce double-walled hydro flask thermos. Watch as I make this hydro flask disappear. Of course, you can mount it to your handlebars like any normal feed bag, but I've also been attaching it to the rear rack of my fat bike. In the summer, you can carry a thermos with ice cold water for countless hours. For winter fat biking, it's great for hot tea or soup broth. They also make it in a zillion color options if you don't want to be boring like me. Just what you want to see a chamois in your face, right? Not to be confused with the Devil's Kettle, but these are Canyon bibs made by Kettle. K-E-T-L. They're owned by Worldwide Cyclery. I'm not usually a bibs guy. I tend to go with baggy shorts and sometimes a chamois liner for bikepacking. But in an effort to mitigate saddle sores a little better, I decided to try these bibs, and so far, so good. They have a comfy chamois and are designed to be worn under baggy shorts. The bibs themselves are mesh and stretchy and breathe very well. The best feature, in my opinion, are the three massive pockets in the back. They offer great storage options for bikepacking, especially if you're not wearing a traditional jersey. Stoked to have these in the arsenal. I chatted about these in my cold hands video, and they always find their way into my glove system. They are Z-Pax Virtus Ultralight Waterproof Mitts. Need I say more? These are the perfect just-in-case item to throw over your regular bike gloves. They weigh nothing, pack down to nothing, they're seam-sealed, and are legitimately waterproof. They can make the difference between warm, useful fingers and wet, numb, useless digits. A no-brainer. While I'm on the ultralight tip, why not talk about ultralight tubes? Of course I ride tubeless, but we still need to carry tubes, unfortunately. Regular butyl tubes take up a lot of space in your pack and can be pretty heavy, especially if you're riding a plus or fat bike. I know they're nothing new or novel, but this year I got on board with carrying tubalitos for spare tubes. In addition to being tiny and ultralight, they actually work. Depending on the trip, I'll also carry a real tube because I'm still nervous about tubalitos for extended use. But for a spare and temporary use, it's awesome. So if you normally carry two spare tubes and swap out one for a tubalito, it's still worth it. For winter fat biking, I've been carrying something similar. These are Revaloop fat tubes. They're basically just tubalitos for fat tires. The weight and size savings are huge compared to normal fat tubes. If you haven't already, give them a shot. Saddle choice is subjective and personal, so I don't discuss them much because what works for me probably won't work for you. So take this with a grain of salt, but I'm absolutely loving the Brooks C13 carved saddle. I threw it on my cutthroat this summer before JP's gravel pursuit, and it's been an absolute game changer for me. It's the perfect blend of a sleek, racy cross-country saddle with the forgiving all-day comfort that Brooks is known for. It has carbon rails to keep the weight down, but is still flexy where it needs to be. I like the feel of the natural rubber material, and the cutout gives pressure relief where you need it. I love it so much that I swapped it from Sunny to Sylvester here, and I'll be using it all winter. Seriously, check out this saddle if you're in the market. Jesus, Louises. Seriously, check out this saddle if you're in the market. This little doohickey is called a Space Link, and it's made by Rockgeist right here in North America. They've been making them for a few years and I've always been curious, so I finally ponied up the dough. Now I'm probably gonna order a couple more so I don't have to keep swapping between bikes. As we know, most, if not all, top tube bags use Velcro or bungees or something else like it to secure them to your fork's steer tube. And most feed bags use Velcro to secure them to the stem. For me, a Velcro rub while I'm turning my bars is extremely annoying. It makes crunchy noises, not to mention it can mar up your nice stem. The Space Link installs easily as a 6mm headset spacer. This allows you to direct mount your gas tank and or feed bags. It's secure and especially helpful if you're running a short stem. Now my bars turn smooth and quiet, and my bags are mounted nice and tidy. A quick disclaimer, Rockgeist designed it to be used with their cockpit bags, so obviously they won't guarantee it for use with other brands. But I've had good success adapting it for use with my other bags. Just saying. Lastly, these little puppies are Tailfin SFMs. You may have heard of them. If not, SFM stands for suspension fork mounts. Simply stated, they are clamps that allow you to mount bottle cages or cargo cages to the lower legs of your suspension fork. I've been doing this for years with Salsa Nicholas cages and hose clamps without issue. And honestly, these don't necessarily work any better, especially if you're on a tight budget. But they are rock solid, install and remove way faster than hose clamps, and allow you to use any cage of your choice. They also give you the option of mounting two cages on one fork leg. Pretty sweet. So if you're into epic rides and bikepacking with a squishy fork and want some extra storage capabilities, definitely check these out. They have Gucci carbon versions or more budget-friendly alloy options. On a side note, I've also been using Tailfin's cargo cages lately. They come in three sizes and are super well designed too. And there you have it, my 11 favorite bikepacking purchases and upgrades of 2022. Do me a favor, if you have any related upgrades, gear, or tips that'll increase people's bikepacking stoke level, share them in the comments down below. Same with any questions, I'll try to answer them as quick as possible. If you enjoyed this video, give us a like, and please consider subscribing to the channel. As always, ride bikes, give back, pay it forward. Thanks so much for squeezing dirty teeth into your busy schedule. Please help us reach more people and ensure you receive new videos by giving this video a like, subscribing to the channel, and clicking the notification bell. Until next time, ride bikes, give back, pay it forward.